Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Barbie Dolls of the Week. Looks like I have Barbie dolls on my head, by the way. I just noticed. Anyway, this week we're going to talk about Barbie fashions. And I'm talking about through several decades. So we're going to look at examples of dolls, fashions on dolls from the 60s, 70s, and 80s, and maybe even a couple from the 90s. But we're going to start with the 60s, and I have two dolls that I want to show you. And as you may remember, I don't collect dolls from the 60s, but I have some outfits. And the first one, which you guys have seen this if you've watched my previous videos, is this one here. And yes, she does have a lot of hair, and I'm still gonna try to find something to pin it back so that it looks better. But big 80s hair, I'm thinking. I think she's from the 80s, but the doll is from the 60s, or excuse me, the dress. So I just think this is really nice. As I've showed before, it has a metal zipper, which is a little splayed at the back here. It's a little, needs a little sewing, but it's still, the dress is in very good condition for an early 60s, early to mid 60s dress. The sewing on it, you can see, is excellent. I mean, it's just such quality work. And I think overall it's a beautiful dress. I'm not sure this is the perfect Barbie to put in it, or the perfect doll, I mean, but I like her in it, and for now it'll stay. Don't like the earrings with that, but I don't want to take them out because they're original to her. So this is an example of a 60s doll, a dress, and it's really cool, I think. Okay, and here's another one. I think I like this one even a little more, though the color is not my favorite. This is a similar kind of dress. You see how well it fits this doll. She does have a bit of gaping going on in the back. This one doesn't have the zipper. It has metal snaps, which you see. And again, it's a very well-made dress. I mean, the detail, you wouldn't find anything like this in today's market for Barbie. And that's sad, I think, in a way, but it's just such good quality, and the workmanship. It's just, only thing is that gaping in the back, which of course could be fixed. So this is another example of a early to mid 60s dress. And I think they had so many cool fashions back then. I wish I personally liked the dolls better, but I'm just not a big fan. So that's why I sold those two that I got earlier in the year through an auction, or through a flea market, actually. Now let's move on to some examples from the 70s. And probably one of the quintessential dolls of Barbie from the 70s is Superstar Barbie. And that's from 1977. Although they had some after that too, but I mean originally from 1977. And this is an original doll in her outfit. It's certainly not perfect. It's got a tear back here in the back that somebody could fix, but I'm not too worried about it. It's just for display. And this is, of course, has this stole, and not everyone would wear that, so you could also take that off and just drape it on your shoulder. Anyway, she's got her jewelry. And you can see that it's a much longer fashion. It's still fairly well made. Not quite the detail and the quality, I don't think, of those early ones. But yeah, this is a good example of a 70s outfit. A lot of people wore dresses like this when they were going to something fancy. I mean, you think of Cher in the 70s, and even Suzanne Somers, you might see her in maybe not this pink, but something long and kind of slinky like this. So that's one example of a 70s dress, a famous one from the world of Barbie. Another one that's much more simple, but also does remind me of the 70s quite a bit, because I saw a lot of women in dresses like this in the 70s, including family members, is a simple sundress. And you see that here on this African-American Magic Curl Barbie. So now the bow puts it a little into doll world, I guess, because I didn't see that much big bows on the back of adult women. But anyway, the dress itself, I like this dress a lot. It does seem very authentic to the period. You know, and it wasn't always this long, obviously, but this gives the child at the time more to play with. And I like the color, especially on her. It's very vibrant. So this is a sundresses were popular in the 70s, and this is a good example of one. And if you kind of go like this for a minute and take the bow out of the picture just temporarily, it's even more realistic. So 70s in that one. One other 70s one, and I could show you lots of 70s dresses, but I just want to show some examples from each, not too many. This is a 70s outfit on another superstar Barbie. This was probably, I'm assuming, well, would have been purchased separately. And this is this one here. That's sort of a wrap around and tied here. And of course, you could tie it different ways. You could have this in the front. But anyway, it'd be tied. And this kind of folds down a little bit. This, I don't know that I saw too many people wearing this, but maybe this was more early 70s. I don't have my book with me. I'm not sure exactly when this is from. Definitely a lot more casual. I still kind of like it. It looks cool and comfortable. And of course, people are calling right now, but we'll ignore that. Okay, so that's some examples of 70s dresses. Now, 80s, let's look at this one first. This is a doll that sort of was part of the transition from the 70s to the 80s, which is Golden Dream. Now, this one has, of course, been out of the box for quite some time, and the outfit is far from perfect. It's got the issue with the pants sagging when you keep them sitting in a sitting position. That tends to happen. It's unfortunate, but this was a really kind of disco, I don't know, Studio 54 kind of thing. And it had a lot of pieces. A lot of the outfits and dolls in the late 70s and definitely into the early to mid 80s, the superstars, they had a lot of fashion accessories, pieces that you could put in different places. Like this could go in her hair too. And they would always show you on the box what you could do. But this is a good example, I think, of something that transitioned from the 70s into the 80s. And of course, it's a little on the garish side with that gold, but she is Golden Dream, so it makes sense in that regard. And like I said, she's got one thing I like is the pieces for her arms. Those are kind of cool. So this is Golden Dream. And moving on, one of the things I think, one Barbie that is so quintessentially 80s is Fashion Jeans Barbie. And again, she's got a little bit of gaping with the pants, but let me button them first, and that will help because some of these tend to come unbuttoned when they're sitting. And this is a little out of shape from the over the years, but it's in pretty good shape. So this is Fashion Jeans Barbie, and these earrings, I don't know where they came from because I don't think they were original to her. I'm 99.9% positive, but they look okay with this. This is, kind of a Jordache jean looking thing. It's got the big label. Instead of Jordache, it says Barbie. And imagine that. It's got the pink, or she's got the pink boots. And just to me, this screams early 80s or mid 80s. I know she's from the early 80s, but I think people were still wearing stuff like this into the mid 80s in some cases. So this is a great 80s fashion that. There were others like it as well. And of course, you guys know that in the little fashion books that would come with these dolls, we give you all kinds of other examples that you could buy different outfits from the time period. And they're also good when you see them nowadays just to know what was around and what's out there and what you might be able to find on sites like eBay or other places. Now, moving on in the 80s just a little bit is Dream Date Barbie, and this is a kind of a Dynasty inspired, I think, 80s dress. This one is new out of the box, so she has much better, everything's in much better shape. Of course, the rubber band is long gone from her hair, except now I see one more piece here, but she's looking good. She's looking brand new, and that's the way I love to see them. But of course, they don't all, especially the ones I've had for many years. But you know, you've got the shoulder puff going on, and you know, this whole thing that could be put in different arrangements on her, the wraparound skirt, but very fashionable, very night on the town. So, cool outfit, cool doll, very 80s. And the last one from the 80s I want to show you is fashion, or not fashion jeans, I already showed you that. Day to Night Barbie. You know, it was about power, women in power, executives, kind of like Alexis Carrington or someone like that, maybe Linda Gray on Dallas, and her hat keeps falling off. But fashion jeans Barbie, and she has this cool pink suit. Now, again, not too many people would probably wear a bright pink suit, but I do think the suit is somewhat representative of other kinds, and also the fabric, maybe not that fabric, but it looks 80s to me. It looks like 80s Barbie. Gotta remember, all this is Barbie fashion, so it's inspired by Barbie, it's for Barbie. And also with the influences of that time period. And I think that's important to keep in mind when you're looking at Barbie fashions, that this is not meant for a woman, a real woman. This is inspired by the time period and what people were wearing, but it's for Barbie. So it's kind of changed in that regard. And by the way, just another reminder, and the hat fell off again, is the other side of day to night, the nighttime look, where you turn it. And this is just one of my very favorite fashions, because it was just so clever, I thought, that oh my gosh, you can just flip everything around and you're ready to go on the town for a night. And of course, the necklace I added, and this hairpiece was added at some point, but it's her scarf. So anyway, this is the daytime, or excuse me, the nighttime version, and she's definitely looking kind of hot. And you could do different things with the hair, of course. Okay, just a couple other ones I want to show you on today's episode of Barbie Fashions, or about Barbie Fashions, and then we'll probably do a follow-up one. But this is a fashion that I really like. This is a Generation Girl Barbie. I'm sure you remember her, those who know. First of all, look at those shoes. Pretty cool. And I like that they are attached so that they don't constantly fall off like so many do. That's why they're still on her. And she's got her sunglasses in hand here. And then this cool little jacket with a zipper or tie at the end here. Let you see. And the dress, I like this dress, and the necklace, it's kind of cool. I mean, I wish it wasn't so obviously plastic. That's probably the only thing I don't like. I like her hair. It's not always in the back cut real nice, like it would be, you would hope, by a professional hairdresser. But from the front, she certainly is a pretty picture. And the makeup is really nice on this doll. Can't see it quite as well as I can in person, but I just think this is a really nice fashion. And this is, of course, later in time. Okay, and the last one for today, which is this doll, by the way, is from the Classique series of Barbie dolls. A very underrated, I think, series of dolls. A lot of beautiful dolls in there. These are mostly in the 90s, and or maybe all. And this is Midnight Gala. And here's what she looks like. And this is a huge cape, or I guess you would call this a cape. Let me see if I can push it up on her. That can go around her like this. And it's a pretty stunning doll, I think. You know, it's not quite to the caliber of today's dolls, like the adult collector line, I mean. A lot of flashy jewelry, and of course, like sequin looking things. It's a pretty long cape, and it's like a black velvet type thing. But this is just really cool, and if you take that down and you just get a good look at the dress, again, a lot of sequin looking things, which of course it's really glitter on her, and embroidered looking. I mean, the hair matches, the hair piece here matches the jewelry and the top of the dress. So I just think it's a great doll. I gave one of these to a friend. I had an extra one, and I gave one to a friend for his 40th birthday, because he collects Barbie too. And he really, really enjoyed this. I wanted this doll for a long time before I got it. And, a lot of times today you can get classic dolls online really rather cheap. So I would look into it if you're interested. This is just one example. They weren't all quite like that. They were very different. But a wonderful line of dolls. So, with that, I'm going to close for today, and I hope you've enjoyed this look at Barbie fashions from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and beyond. And next time, we'll look at some other Barbie fashions and compare them as well. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.